Japanese Defense Ministry on Tokyo Bay, Tokyo, Japan. Admiral Otomo and the Japanese I-SDF are responsible for working with Douglas Shetland to push the Koreas and the United States into war. It must be determined if Otomo's actions are sanctioned by the Japanese government and Otomo must be stopped. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome to the final episode of Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, played in a tactical assault playstyle. Needless to say, I will attempt to take out as many people as I can, but this section has a no-kill restriction on us, so it might just be a little difficult. So thus far, somebody was trying to get their hands on Masse Kernel-enabled information warfare algorithms. That person turned out to be Shetland through a series of, breadcrumbs left behind by him, unwittingly, of course. And the NSA picked up on them and figured out it was Shetland. But in the last level, Bathhouse, what we figured out was Shetland was trying to sell it to somebody, and it turned out to be none other than the Japanese ISDF. Now, the question at hand is, that we need to figure out is it actually the entirety of the ISDF that holds the same stance, or is the ISDF just acting on behalf of the Japanese government's will? Is Japan trying to remilitarize and plot world dominance or something of that sort? Because it actually did try to goad the US into war against its enemies, namely China and North Korea. So, yeah, we essentially need to figure out how deep this conspiracy runs, or whether it's just a splinter cell, or rather a splinter faction of controlled by General Otomo. So, with that being said, let's check out the cinematic.
Events today jeopardized diplomatic efforts when North Korean armor encountered a so-called self-healing minefield while attempting to withdraw from the area.
North Korean forces were adequately cautioned that self-healing minefields along the DMZ should not be considered cleared obstacles. We're back at the brink of war, and now we find out it is the Japanese?
The Japanese are allies.
I don't care if they're the Christmas elves. They sank the Walsh.
We don't know that their government was involved.
We know Admiral Otomo was involved, and we know where the gentleman is. We have to go in now, immediately.
The fact is, we don't know how far the conspiracy goes. If Otomo's actions are sanctioned by the Japanese government, then the only solution is military. But if he's acting alone...
Your man again?
He's already in position.
Send him in.
The State Department has lost contact with all of the U.S. officers who work at the Kokubo Sosho with the Japanese Self-Defense Force. It looks like the SDF have taken them prisoner, and they're refusing to answer our calls. In typical fashion, the Japanese are circling their wagons. Either they're afraid to admit they've lost control of Otomo, or they're actually sanctioning him. If that's the case, we'll have to come clean with North Korea, which will spark a massive war in Asia. If not, we need to find out what our officers know and figure out what to do about Otomo before North Korea finds out what's going on.
Sam, even if the Japanese government is not sanctioning him, Otomo still clearly has the capacity to strike. If he's still in control of the information arm of the SDF, you'll need to deal with him very carefully. There's no telling what kind of havoc he could unleash.
Last contact we had with any U.S. personnel in the Kokubo Sosho was a fragment of a phone call from Major Harper, a logistics advisor to GSDF. From the sounds of the call, the room he was in was raided by Japanese troops, and he was taken prisoner. It doesn't sound like anyone has been killed, and if there's any hope of maintaining peaceful relations with the Japanese, you're going to have to keep it that way.
Exactly. So I will try killing people, though. I will try it out. It'll probably just get it to where I can only, I have to just complete my primaries and then just leave. That's all I can do, I suppose. But the reason that what Grim talks about, essentially the fact that he has the capability to strike, is essentially the evidence that we need to conclude that it was actually Otomo who launched the missile at the USS Walsh, in conjunction with the fact that the attack actually came from Japan itself, and the fact that they're trying to obtain the Masse Kernels. I don't know how it worked, though, the fact that they're trying to obtain the Masse Kernels at the same time that let me rephrase that. I don't know how it works, the fact that they they launched the attack even though they did not have the Masse Kernels yet. But anyhow, we do see punch card machines in the basement, and it's again Otomo essentially launches a North Korean missile at one of his own cities. I think it was Hokkaido, if I'm not wrong. But they essentially, Otomo essentially tried to use the US to do his dirty work for him and keep his own fingers clean. So, yeah, let's go ahead and let us take the assault loadout, because, well, it more or less gives us everything. We get a shotgun attachment with this, and we do have launcher attachment, which is really nice. We do also have sticky shockers and sticky cameras, and gas grenades, and a foil rounds, the whole shebang, all that we could ask for. So, frags and smokes, everything. So, let's go ahead and get this in.
Fisher, I can't stress this enough. If one Japanese soldier dies, we risk World War III. Any fatalities and I abort the mission immediately.
I understand.
Locate our officers and find out what the hell is going on there.
I'll find them.
Okay, let's test that theory. Even though Lambert said that, let us go ahead and test that theory though.
God damn it, Fisher! Can't you follow orders?
Lambert, I...
That's it, Fisher. Mission over.
Really? Oh, damn. Okay. It's strange that these guys can't see me. Wait, I'm in the shadows. Because they're right in front of the gate. I was wondering that why they can't see me yet. Come on. I'm not gonna pick the lock, I'm just gonna go ahead and break it. Yeah, I was sort of waiting for those guys to stop speaking, even though most of you all can't understand what's being said anyway. Let them detect what they're gonna detect. It doesn't really matter. Saving gear. Maybe I should just go ahead and knock this guy out. Nice to meet you. Right then. Now what attachment should we use first? Sticky shocker? Makes sense. For now, I mean. I'll just wait for you to sit down on the computer. I don't know who you were talking to over there. But probably somebody inside that room over there, I suppose.
God damn it, Fisher! Can't you follow orders?
Lambert, I...
That's it, Fisher. Mission over.
He's probably talking to that guy out there. I'll just leave him lying there. And we'll head upstairs. Towards that guy. Since he has no clue where we are, we're gonna use that to our advantage. Ah, there you are. Not the shotgun attachment though, I want the launcher attachment instead. Much better attachment. I would rather use the airfoil ring round for the next section here. Don't know whether approaching from this side is the more tactically sound choice or not. But yeah, we're gonna try it nonetheless. Seems to be... we seem to be in the shadows right here. Right then. Now it's your turn. I'm just gonna walk up behind you and I'm gonna knock you out the old fashioned way. With a smack to the ear. That's how you knock people out. By smacking them across the ear. Alright then. Just in case that sweeper sees any of these guys. Okay, now to talk without that camera getting in the way.
Alright guys, what's going on here?
Thank God, an American, ready to go when you are.
Slow down, I'm not your babysitter.
That's
Tell
true.
Me what you know, and maybe somebody will come get you later.
Well, SDF rounded up all the U.S. personnel and locked us up. We saw some generals and ministers being brought in earlier.
Where did they go?
Into the war room in the sub-level.
The doors to the lower levels are sealed.
A captain was just up here looking for combat-ready volunteers to go down there. Maybe the doors are open now.
Thanks for the tip.
Sam, we need to record everything that happens in that meeting so we can present it to the Joint Chiefs.
It would speed things up if you'd let me remove some of the threats.
Forget it, Fisher. Until we know who the enemy is, there is no enemy. No enemy means no kills. Deal with it.
Alright. Well, I sort of got the misconception that they might not be as harsh with the penalties because of how... when you're in the penthouse and you kill some National Guard, Lambert doesn't really do anything. He just... essentially cancels your primaries is all it does. But I suppose when it comes to the actual action itself, comes to these levels, maybe in the space we are actually not allowed to kill anybody. It would make sense. These elevators are on lockdown, we cannot actually access them, we will have to rely on the stairs. Nobody here. We have effectively knocked everybody out, which is good. Which is just the way that I like things to be. Just excuse me there for a second. Alright, moving on then. I'm gonna be trying something here.
Fisher, from the looks of it, these guards are LTL equipped.
Less than lethal. Why?
There's only one reason I can think of that they'd issue them to combat troops. They'll want to interrogate anyone they catch.
Well, I'm not the talk of that type.
Wrong thing.
Be more careful, Fisher. This mission couldn't be more sensitive.
Yes, okay, you saw some bodies on camera there. It's a nice touch. It really is a nice touch. Not what I wanted. Whoops. Yeah, That's what I'm trying to find. The camera seems to be stuck. So I'll just move along here. Clear this area. It's clear. All three of these guys are right here. Probably could have used somebody's eyes on that thing there, but alright. Saving. Better to save before attempting something. 194, and I think the last number was a 20. Yes, it is. 194 and 20, only one number left. So, the tolerances in this level are pretty low, as you can probably tell. Do I have... Yeah, I've got two A4 ring rounds. And as you can see, the light's coming all the way out. Okay, we need to move slow. I don't think there is anybody here. Wait, despite an alarm, nobody actually... Huh, that's interesting. I was pretty sure that because of the alarm, people would be here, but... And that the servers would actually retract into the floor, because that's how it's supposed to be. The servers are supposed to retract into the floor once the alarm sounds. But I guess that's not always the case. Now, the thing is, if you scan this computer, you can actually probably find the tow code required for that. Is that the... Yeah, that's it. No, but I think that only gives us access to the door code here. 10, alright. Yeah, just the server room cameras and nothing else. Okay, that did not work. Well, we don't really need him anyway, so might as well just go ahead and head back. Unless I want to shock this guy, maybe. Maybe use an air fault ring round on him. I suppose no alarms were raised yet. Nope, no alarms were raised yet. Cool. We're all out of ring A-fall rounds, but we do still have two sticky shockers that we can use for the guards up ahead. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Smooth. Smoothly done. And is there anything else here, though, that we can take? There are only two guys here, not more. This, typically, if you get caught, your equipment will be here. I believe I've already shown how that works in during the... You know, field interrogator playthrough where I did like a reverse interrogation of these guys. you can actually find this. I do believe I showed that. Yeah. All right. That's that for this section. Moving on. I love it when the level actually gives you stuff that you can use. Don't know if that actually did anything, but yeah, it did. Cool.
Fisher, GPS shows you're nearing the war room. Intelligence says it's a tempest-hardened cube. The only way you'll be able to record what's going on in there is to find some way inside.
Tempest hardening might keep out electronic intruders, but I'm betting the room isn't airtight.
Probably not.
Right. First, let's just go ahead and take that camera out. And I'll use the speed boost granted to me by... Holy shit, that's right.
That's two alarms, Sam. Why not just tell everyone you're there?
Okay. If you insist, Lambert. If you really want me to do that, I'll go ahead and do that. Alright. I'll just close the recording here because the game crashed here at one point in time, so... Right then. Okay.
Sam, I've got some details on the building's infrastructure. This vent should come out directly over the war room.
I'll try and laser mic the meeting from there.
Good. We'll let you know when we have enough to make the Joint Chiefs happy.
So perhaps it's where this mod will shine.
Hello.
オートモ幕僚長です。オートモ君、どういうことかね、これは。戦後憲法を廃止し、直ちに日本の再軍備を開始し、我が国の意思決定を天皇陛下のもとへとお返しするのです。米国は政治的にも軍事的にもこの決定に従います。自らをこれ以上の経済的軍事的な拘束から解放するために、こうして両国の大東亜圏における関係に
終止符が打たれることになります。そんな不可能だ。たとえ憲法を廃止できても天皇は決して。天皇は軍部の指示に従います。私は話のわからぬ男ではございません。これらの策の実行には時間を要します。あなた方の名誉と分別は信用しています。したがって96時間の猶予を差し上げましょう。96時間、 国民がそのような暴挙を許すものか。もし4日以内にこれらの要求に応じられない場合、私は北朝鮮の弾道ミサイルを強制発射させ、我が国の都市のいずれかを壊滅させることで見せしめとします。残念なことに、これにより何百万の死者が出ることでしょう。ですがあなた方の呼びかけで民意を奮い立たせることができぬ以上やむを得ません。あなた方の名誉のため、そして我らが祖国のために、そのような決断を私に強いることのないよう
Good God, Fisher. That confirms it. Otomo has been manipulating the Japanese government the entire time.
At least they're not sanctioning his actions. What's the next step? How do we stop Otomo?
If we're lucky, we might not have to.
What do you mean?
Grim?
I'm worried about that general, Fisher. He's been awfully quiet working on his laptop. Access it from here. Let's see what he's planning.
Will do.
再接続中。作戦部こちら中央。艦取り横。了解。導任配置に着いた。待機。導任。状況開始。繰り返し。状況開始。 Basically attempting to assault Otomo right now. Otomo previously gave them 96 hours for an ultimatum, and this was this is their response, essentially an armed response using force. Which pisses Otomo off. And the GSDF troops get wiped out.
から通信です。大友君、我々は愚かな。愚策を練るなど時間の無駄でしょう。名誉をもって行動できるのであれば、力ずくで従わせるまでです。北朝鮮のミサイルで内地の都市が消滅すれば、もはや民意の高ぶりを防ぐことはできますまい。どの都市が対象となるのかは着弾をもって一方といたしましょう。考えられる手は。So
he launches a missile at his own country.
天皇にはどう伝える？Good
Lord! Otomo is going to launch a North Korean missile at his own country.
What's the time frame?
Could be hours, could be minutes. Get down there and destroy his servers.
What about extraction?
If you can't take out those servers before Otomo forces a launch, there won't be any reason to extract.
And if I do take out the servers?
We'll make that part up as we go.
That's half a plan if I've ever heard one.
Come on, move it. Enough crouch running. Alright, time to equip the shotgun because we're gonna lose the no kill restriction soon. I do not think there's anybody here. Express elevator.
I just got off the horn with the Joint Chiefs. I'm lifting the non-lethal mission parameter. Fifth freedom with everyone except Otomo.
Except You're Otomo. Kidding.
We need to capture him alive. His profile is pretty clear. He won't lie to a war crimes tribunal in the face of the evidence. It would offend his sense of honor.
You need him to take responsibility so the rest of Japan is off the hook with North Korea.
Exactly. If Otomo dies, we're right back at square one. Bring him in breathing.
Nice move, Otomo. Now it's my turn to play some cards. Hopefully, the cards I play will be right. And we're headed all the way underwater to the very bottom of Tokyo Bay. And it is a deep bay. Alright, time to head down. This section is always a little finicky. Yeah, I'm grabbing this side. Okay.
Fisher, North Korea just contacted NORAD and the President. They report that they've lost control of a launch facility. They can't abort and they're not sure that they can destroy the missile on time.
How long?
They say 3 minutes until it's away.
I think I can reach the server in time.
Yep.
Hurry up!
Alright, time to shoot this guy first. Whoa, that's advanced tactics right there. So I just fought these guys, and these guys were using some advanced tactics. Alright. Like, one of these guys, he actually flanked me and he lay down on the ground before taking shots at me. Really advanced tactics. Really impressive as well. Alright, moving on. What, you think you saw something? I'm gonna show you what you saw. I'm gonna show you exactly what you saw. Okay, we need to deactivate that thing again. I don't know who else is shooting at me, but somebody definitely is. Okay, time to flank them. Flanking. Oh, come on, stop it. I hate it when that happens. It's like a bug of... Yeah, I don't know where he is, where the last guy is. Should be right here, but I don't know where he is. Time to place a charge here. And while we're at it, might as well use the computer. Okay, fine. 194. 66 and 10. And it's not 30, so it's 20.
Good thinking, Fisher.
Any line on what's going on in this place can only help.
Absolutely.
Okay, time to...
They say 60 seconds until it's away.
If you say so. I can detonate the charge from here.
Thank God, Fisher. That aborted the launch.
Yeah, but I think it woke up the neighbors.
Get it's through them, Fisher. Then bring in Otomo alive.
My pleasure.
Did not think there were more folks hidden away back there. But turns out I was wrong. There are at least two more right here. Right then. Well then, that's that. Since the servers are offline, this thing isn't working either. So, the punch card machines that I was talking about, they're right here. See, look at these. Punch card machines. For the sake of Dvorak. How is this place receiving any light? I guess this is big to data. Well, we're completely done with everything here. Alright, time to talk to Otomo then. Otomo, my friend.
Give it up, Admiral. It's over.
You think that I will surrender to you? You think that I will allow your people to strip me of my dignity? Throw me in chains? No, I think not. My people have endured your charming oppression for more
charming
than
60
years.
You say tomato.
Americans, always turning to their jokes when their hearts are full of fear. And you should be afraid. I may be defeated, but I am a man, and ideas are stronger than men. You may even prevent this war, American, but the dragon has awoken, and he will not be so easily sedated this time.
Go on, stab yourself. Good job.
Now what?
I think someone is taking himself a bit too seriously.
We can't afford to let him die, Fisher. Get in there and stabilize him. Fast.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Lambert, sir. But before that, I would just like to access his computer. I could not do that the previous time around. Can I not? Yeah, use this computer. See what's on file. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. A whole lot of zilch. Nada. Nothing. Alright, let's save Otomo. Pulling the knife out, that's a bad decision. I mean, the knife's the only thing
good
that's keeping the blood.
He's stable, but we still have to get him out of there. You're going to have to blast your way out.
We're over 100 feet underwater.
You're not pressurized, Fisher. It will be a shock, but you won't get the bends.
Next time, you're going on the mission and I'm making up the crazy plan.
Alright, time to place like a wall mine here. Not exactly wall mine, more like a C4 charge. But yeah, that's that. That's how this level ends. Alright, let's go then. Deep breath, Fisher, deep breath.
Admiral Otomo, former head of the Japanese Information Self-Defense Force, made a surprise confession today on the witness stand at the Hague War Crimes Trial. Otomo openly admitted conspiring to instigate war between the Koreas and the United States, claiming that the... In other news, China's ambassador to the United States, Long Dan, received the Nobel Peace Prize today for his efforts in defusing the Korean conflict. President Bowers today addressed the nation following the crisis that brought us to the brink of war.
Finally, I want to take a moment to thank those unsung heroes in the intelligence community who may very well have saved our nation and the world from certain disaster.
Thank you, Mr. President.
The boss seems happy. How about that raise?
They're cutting us back. You'll have to settle for a vacation.
Yeah, right. Alright, so that was that for Kokubo Sosho, as well as Splinter Cell Chaos Theory in a tactical shooter playstyle. And yeah, Do Not Kill Anyone has been cancelled. And we also got access to the I-SDF servers. Now, We got a 60% rating here, which is really nice. We captured Otomo. He fessed up. The Masse Kernels are in the right hands. Well, that's subjective, but yeah, they're not in terrorist hands or in the hands of people seeking to dominate the world. excuse me there. but at any rate, yeah, two bodies were found, two alarms were triggered. Everything is fine and dandy, and that's the end of Chaos Theory for you. Now, let's talk about this mod for a second. I mean, I wanted to mostly... Ooh, final rating 28%. I like it. That's a really nice feeling. Great. I really do like it. It could have been much lower if I had got if I had got less than 90% of displays, but oh well. Yeah, now, as I was saying, this mod makes things far easier, actually, the first-person mod, because it tightens up the spread of your weapon and enables you to walk faster with the weapon drawn, because otherwise I have tried a tactical shooter playstyle even without it, and it is easy. It's not that it's terribly difficult or anything, but at the same time, because your spread, the spread of your weapon is so broad, and... the fact that you cannot move fast with the weapon drawn, that just adds to this issue where repositioning is very difficult. You need to sheath your weapon and then, like, holster your weapon, and then you need to reposition. And at the same time, firefights are very long drawn. You can't exactly, you know, just expect to go in there and snipe everybody. You tend to miss most of your shots, actually. You only hit, like, around maybe 10-20% of your shots, and I feel like maybe that's quite realistic. Maybe not for a Spec Ops slash Navy SEAL like Fisher here, but yeah, I think it might just be pretty realistic for like an average soldier in a firefight, I feel like. Or maybe not, maybe they are deadlier than that, but who knows, because I mean, we are talking CQB battles right here. And another thing that I will note is that even though this game actually does give you the opportunity to play in a more assault sort of fashion, at the same time, apart from the fact that it like totally removes side objectives for you and punishes your score, that's like of natural consequence. One of the things that I found that they had not accounted for with the inclusion of... one of the things that I found that they had not accounted for when it came to actual shootouts is the fact that the enemies, they aren't always smart, because towards the end, with the Spec Ops, with like Shetland's personal bodyguard, and with the GSDF, or rather the I-SDF troops, at the very last level, I don't know whether I included that or not, maybe I should include that, but... those were the only enemies that I saw that were actively flanking me. And the guy at the end, he even lay prone on the ground, playing dead before he shot me, like a literal real-life COD drop shot. Complete with like very slow-moving animation as well. I had actually thought that he had died. And turns out, no, he was just laying prone and shooting at me. Yeah, I mean, most of the times these enemies just head straight at you, head straight for the source of the sound of the disturbance, which is something that's expected of a stealth game, but not of a tactical shooter or even like any standard kind of shooter game. So, yeah, that was a little strange to me, felt quite strange to me. Could have sort of improved on that once a firefight broke out, they could have made it so that it was actually pretty difficult to get through those guys without having to rely on advanced maneuvers. And despite that, it still is, despite using this mod, I have faced certain areas where taking enemies out has been extremely difficult. And I mean, it's sort of a pleasure, but at the same time, it's also painful to deal with. At any rate, that was that for Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Thank you for watching my third playthrough. Thank you for sticking around until not only the end of this video, but also the end of the entire playthrough. So, yeah. We will be covering Double Agent after this. I do not know whether I want to play that game once in a stealthy fashion and once in a tactical assault manner, but yeah, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. I typically don't really like that game too much, so yeah. I also want to cover Double Agent version 2, but I don't have an Xbox and I do not want to play the PS2 version. I do have the PS2 version. I'll play just the first two levels, then I'll beat the bonus levels that are PS2 exclusives, and after that I'll play the Xbox version when I do actually manage to get my hands on an Xbox. I am thinking of emulating it, buying a disc, ripping it, and emulating it, but yeah, I don't know, because the emulator doesn't really work all that well. Anyhow, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, see you soon. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.